Hello everyone. Today we will be studying about the call blocking probability of the GSM network, and we will be looking to how the call blocking probability varies with the load on the GSM network. And for that we are going to use the software of NetSim to simulate this particular theory. So for operating the NetSim software, we have to first go to the simulation. We have to create a new network, and in the new network there will be many networks which you can simulate. We will be going for cellular network, and in cellular network we will be selecting a GSM. Now once you are selecting that network, there will be a environment which will be open, and in this environment you have to create a GSM network. So for creating a GSM network, there will be a default which will be taking as a mobile phone. So we will I am right now for the example I am taking Right now for the example I am taking the mobile phone, and before that I will be taking the base station for connecting the mobile phone. So I will be taking the base station. One base station will be there. Then there will be one mobile switching center, which is MSC, that will be dropped, and then connection to that MSC will be the mobile station. So I am right now dropping a four mobile stations for showing the probability of the GSM network. So four mobile stations are connected to the base BTS with the wireless link, and now we have to join the BTS with the MSC. The established link will be a wired link. So we are connecting a wired link between the base station BTS and between the MSC. So this is the cellular network which is created, for which we are going to find out the call blocking probability. So for running this particular environment, there are some settings which is to be done of the BTS, MSC and the mobile phone. So for the mobile phone, we are taking right now four mobile phones. The properties of the base station has to be set as it is, means the default properties has to be taken. And for the properties of the MSC, we have to right click on the MSC icon and then go for the properties. So for the properties, we will be going for MSC. We have to set the uplink bandwidth in minimum, so that is we have to select 890 megahertz, and bandwidth uplink bandwidth maximum we have to select 890.2 megahertz. So that will be the properties which has to be set, only the bandwidth, and then you have to click on accept. So that property for the MSB has been set. Now to establish a link between the mobile phone so as to study the call blocking probability, we have to drop application menu. So from the application, just drag and drop that application menu here. Then click on the properties of the application, double click on the application, there will be a property which will be displayed for the application. Right now by default there will be one application which will be created, and you can see there are some default properties which are set. So for the application 1, I will be selecting source ID as 3 and I will be selecting destination ID as 5. Duration and all these particular properties we will be taking as it is, and we have to create another application to establish the another link. So create second application, and for the second application the source ID will be 4 and destination ID will be 6. The other property which is to be set for this is the duration, and that duration we are setting it as exponential. Inter arrival time has to be set as constant, and then packet size which is to be set for the network, that packet size in the bytes has to be set, and then we have to say accept for this particular property. As you can see, there are green lines which are established between the mobile phones. So there are connection established between the mobile phone 3 and 5. There is another connection between the mobile phone 4 and 6, and this particular is the applications which are done. Now you have to go to the running of the simulation, so click on run button here, and then set the simulation time as 100 seconds, and then click on OK. So simulation will start and it will take 100 seconds to run the simulation. So here we are obtaining that right now we have taken only 4 mobile phones which are connected to the BTS and they are connected to MSC. After running the simulation, we will be getting the call blocking probability when these mobile phones are connected. So once the simulation is over, you will be getting this particular performance matrices window open. In that, you have to go to the cellular matrix and click on MS matrix. So once you click on MS matrix, you can see there are one call generated from mobile number 3 and mobile number 4, but you can see the call blocking probability, call block are 0 and call blocking probability is also 0. Means what is the meaning here? Because number of mobile phones for the base stations are lesser currently, and because of that this base station is able to support this particular mobile phone, this many number of mobile phones. You can click on saving of the environment, and then you can give any name default and you can save the experiment. Now when you want to open once you are simulating for the 4 mobile phones, what you can do is you can increase another 2 mobile phone by dropping again a mobile station. So I am dropping a mobile station number 7 and mobile station number 8, and then from the application menu I will be adding another application. From the application menu I will be adding another application to establish a link between I will be adding another application to establish a link between the mobile phone number. Added mobile phones are, right now I have added mobile phone number 7 and mobile phone number 8. So I will be clicking on properties of application, and I will be establishing now source ID as 7 and destination ID as 8. And of this I will be selecting interarrival time as exponential, and other we will be keeping other properties as default, and we have to click on accept. So now as you can see in the network, there is a source, there is another 2 mobile phones are added in the network, and I have set the application property in such a way that now there is a link between these 2 mobile phones. And now again when I run for the simulation, I will be again able to check the simulation time has been kept as 100 seconds, and I will be able to check now again probability of this call blocking probability of this network. So currently if you can see, there are 6 mobile phones connected, and we will be able to have a look on that how the probability is increasing or decreasing with the help of increase in the mobile phone. Again there is a perform matrix here, cellular matrix, and in cellular matrix we have to click on MS matrix. And now you can see here there are 2 calls generated, there is 1 call is blocked here, and because of that we can see the blocking probability is increasing. Next time when you again drop the 2 mobile phones, again the blocking probability will be increasing, and this experiment can be repeated like that for 20 mobile phones, and then whatever results we are getting, that results we can export. There is a button here which we can export to the Excel, and we can definitely able to plot the graph between the blocking probability and the sample number of mobile phones, and we will be able to find that number of, with increase in the number of samples, will increase in the number of mobile phones, the call blocking probability will be increasing. Thank you.